In Sierra Leone, if a girl is visibly pregnant, she's not allowed to go to school and she's not allowed to sit exams. So the chance of her dropping out of school is even higher than it would be anyway, because the chance of her going back after she's given birth is minimal. Without completing your education, your chances of, you know, getting a good source of income, good livelihoods opportunities is reduced. And that just contributes to this continued cycle of poverty that gets passed on from generation to generation. In addition to that, in Sierra Leone, we have one of the highest maternal mortality rates in the world. And of those deaths, 40% of those are associated with teenage mothers. So Concern is trying to tackle this issue with a very holistic approach to its programming.
The life skills component actually is working with the adolescents from age 9 to 19 years. And these 9 to 19 years will have a life skills curriculum which we roll out to them. And it's really age appropriate. We have special topics for 9 to 13 years of age, and we also have topics that are related to 14 to 19 years of age. And we also deal with both boys and girls, those in school as well as those out of school.
We have adolescents at the heart of our program, but we also realize that adolescents, just like all of us, don't make decisions without many different influencing factors.
Of course, in trying to address the teenage pregnancy, we cannot just do the children and leave the community people, the parents, as well as the husbands of these adolescents. When you want to change attitude, you need to deal with all this set of peoples. So for this group of peoples, we have separate sessions for them in smaller groups. For the parents, we have outreach sessions for parents of the adolescents who are part of the life skills. We also have separate sessions for husbands, and we also have sessions for community leaders in all the communities.
When they me tell me, they say me picking the right name for this life skill, I say, hey, whose program this? Where then they go teach the picking about mommy and daddy business for let them stop her. Later, me heart been poor, but later, now where they don't start now, I see waiting and they give them, waiting and they tell them, they go explain to me. Now I appreciate the program, I'm glad for the program.
I encourage me to help you to buy me benefits if you know. I'm fed them. So, to the game, come there. Sotori ke dambre ne ke fino salata nga mi metti ro dar o wosi mi to ya fe tamia e kwando me ma spaito yisi o wosi mi ya i tror go pawa tengi ma wenge wenyi fino ai
antre nna nya mar mi because an lo ko se te ira se but sane mi ne o bera at tsaya me ma ko sum ko tsa i tori ko tsa ya violence mo me kira ko ke ma antre nna ndi ande tsoi su pai ma ira o bera ko mo inske encourage ko mpa yo tinotin kama mi fane ko kono so mwe ma tse yi fane mu so si ya peace mo ne kono anta en family.
The other components of the project is the service provision component, wherein we work with the DHMT, the district health management team, and the district, and we help to train their nurses in the provision of adolescent friendly services, so that adolescents from the life skills and even those who are not part of the life skills can get friendly services when they are visited at the PHUs or their health centers. So, and after that, we do provide them with mentors who do go to their health centers on a weekly basis to see how best the training is being put into practice.
Through the program, we've generated great demand for contraceptives by adolescents. The challenge that we're facing is that when they go to the health facilities to get those contraceptives, they're often not available.
We've been using the family planning method, more especially the implants, the injectable and the pills. But now it is not available in a center. We don't have implants, we don't have injectables like depot, and even pills, even the microlith, we don't have it. We have run out of supply. We don't have anything in our center. And these people, they are coming out. So it is very, very challenging.
As a short-term response to this challenge, we've been partnering with Mary Stopes, who provide mobile contraceptive services directly to the communities in which we work.
The impact that we've seen, apart from this increase in demand for contraceptives, has been significant changes in attitudes with many of the stakeholders that we've been working with. We've seen changes in attitudes towards gender norms, violence, power, the ability to talk about this issue. It was something that was so taboo before, and now we've got communities talking about it and championing issues, which is just amazing to see. And I feel that this program has really sown some seeds for some fundamental change.
Most of the time when you say law go na hospital for some contraceptive, that they say no, me and the way for the nurse there. But ever since we join at the life skill, make him go to hospital and he check for me any month. Like if I go for pills, the pills and all day, I go for injection. Maybe then go say 3 months.
My dream, because I know say me picking, you get for do better in future. From this program now, I know say you get for be maybe doctor in future.
Look, I'm fit to no pay. I'm going to be free. Because I'm a PBA, I need study. So I go better. I'm going to school. I'm going to be a teacher. I'm going to study.